while this is not a free shake, we've been talking to you about the changing face of viral video. One of the biggest things today that may be affecting all of us is Google is talking about buying Hulu. You're going, yeah? Well, if they've been talking about buying Hulu and YouTube together, we still take the best of it. But it also could be the end of viral video as we know it. So for now, we're going to bring Oldecam on.
I know. And you thought Oldecam was going to be on here.
No.
Actually, he is going to be here. He's just on the other side of the camera.
Yep.
So, of course, let's see. Well, I guess we'll bring you news. Raise taxes first and talk about cuts when the crisis is over.
I know. Isn't that brilliant? That's the Democrats' idea. That, you know, the Republicans have to give us the tax raises so that we can raise the revenue so that we can cut spending. No, if they're not going to cut spending, because this is what the problem is in Minnesota with the Democrats. They're not trimming any of the budget, and they're demanding tax increases on, but only on the wealthy. And their wealthy determination is any business, anyone that $250,000 a year, which is every small business has ever created, folks.
Well, I also think they're finding out about how quickly that can change, because here in California, the day after Jerry Brown signed it.
Yeah.
Was it day after? Okay. Anyway, Amazon decided to end their associate program in the state of California.
Yeah.
Which, who thought they would react that fast?
They are reacting because they're just, I love the a-holes in the press. We're the most under-taxed nation in the free world. No, we're the most taxed nation in the free world.
I think they should pay more taxes then.
Oh, they hit somebody. They had yesterday, I love this, one of the Republican leaders to one of the moron Democrats in the press. Okay, I'll give you taxes back to the Clinton era if we return the spending to the Clinton era. And they, well, we can't do that because there's so many people that are suffering because the people have been unjustly making money too long. See, they have no intentions of cutting spending.
It's just, no, see, that's part of it. Well, you know, I think, you know, if you think there should be more taxes, I think that there's nothing in it that says you can't pay more taxes than you want, you know what I mean, than you're supposed to.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, anybody, here's a good one. It was Bill Clinton that put in the tax thing for the jet industry. So that the jet business could be, because it was dying, they were shipping all the, people were building jets out of this country, so he got the tax put in so that they would start building jets in this country again. And Obama voted as a senator to extend that tax.
Oh, so,
you know why?
Well, actually, he did make a vote. Most of his things were with the president.
Yeah, no, but he voted to extend it because they build corporate jets and Illinois.
Oh, actually, I think there's something in here about corporate jets, but we'll be getting to that one. Oh,
yeah.
Wait, Obama. Bush cut the taxes on people with corporate jets, which is why we have the crisis we are in.
I know. It was a cut by Bill Clinton in order to stimulate the economy. So, because, like they said, if you taxed the corporate jets for 5,000 years, it wouldn't come to 1 year of Obama's spending.
I did notice what you said, which is they cut taxes to stimulate the economy, which is about the reverse of what they're currently talking about, which is you increase taxes to stimulate the economy.
Yeah.
The clowns,
actually, up until the time that they Amazon pulled out of California Associates, they were touting this tax increase as a jobs program. We'll be able to use this money to help keep people working that are no longer working because they've lost their jobs. So now they put like 10,000 people out of work, and they're gonna, when eBay pulls out and YouTube pulls out, all of these things with associate programs pull out of California, the amount of unemployment is going to be massive, and they said they're already gonna lose $100 and some million that they get
oh, really?
From Amazon to begin with in taxes are now gone.
Now they're gone.
Yep.
And government, China's inflation to rise in June.
Yeah, I can hear that with airplanes.
China's inflation.
Oh yeah, that market is going up on the fact that inflation in China is going up, which makes things too expensive to buy. And if they're too expensive to buy, why is the market going up on the? It was ridiculous this morning. They're all cheering over automobile sales being up over last year when they were down. They're not saying
well, actually, that is good, though.
No, but they're not up. They're still down. I mean, Chrysler sales are 30% higher than they were last year. And, but General Motors is actually down.
But they got to rejoice at anything they can.
But they're not selling cars. Well, we're selling cars that the government cars, the cars that are green are selling at a rapid rate. No, they're not.
Maybe some of them were used to make that new Transformers movie. They did bust up some cars in there, didn't they?
I know. A lot of cars supplied by General Motors, folks.
Ooh. Assault case against ex-IMF leader near collapse.
Oh, it is collapse.
Now, come on.
She admitted this morning she lied to the grand jury. The case is dead. They dropped, he is no longer out on bail. They haven't dropped charges, but they dropped his bail entirely because it seems like the woman has also used the rape thing before.
Well, you know, see, here's the part of it that doesn't get changed is he is still the ex-IMF leader.
Oh, no, but
they don't reinstate him.
No, but it puts him back in the, they said they have basically, here's a good one. Obama wanted the guy gone because they thought that he would, he was heavily favored to win the presidency of France, and he doesn't believe in Obama's policies to spend. What happened, they said, Obama basically elected him to the presidency today.
Oh, because now everybody feels sorry for him.
Oh, yeah. But no, they said the United States engineered all of this. Now, they're absolutely going to say the United States engineered everything because they knew this woman was lying. She'd hurt her shoulder so bad that she had to go to a doctor and couldn't do anything. Well, she went back to work right after she supposedly was attacked. Then contacted her lawyer, and her lawyer told her what to do. Why would you call a lawyer first and then go to the police? That she's not even going to get any money from him, which is a bad... Well, but she's got what... Okay, the assumption is she had problems with the INS... Obama will drop all of the immigration problems with her, and she gets her citizenship for bringing this testimony against the guy. But it backfired. As everything Obama has done in the last few weeks has been a disaster.
That is bad.
Yeah.
That's bad. And Asian markets higher after Greek confidence vote.
Well, yeah, they're going to throw the government out. So they passed the austerity budget, and the people are going to throw the government out.
Really?
Which means the Greeks have... The austerity measures didn't work the first time they were passed a year ago because there was a threatening of the government. The majority power party is winning by 5 votes. You toss as many as 6 people out and the austerity program is finished. And they're wanting to throw the entire government out. So
that's not good.
That's right.
And Venezuela's Chavez has surgery removed cancerous tumor.
Yeah, he's admitting he does have cancer now, which which means they said he's in ill health and he does have cancer. And but what happens is you can't even keep things secret in Cuba, which is why he went there to have it done instead of the United States.
Oh, really?
Here's a good one. The medical care in Cuba is the best care in the world. Well, he had to go back. He had to go back a second time. Because they didn't fix the problem the first time. They're fishing around to take him to some other country in order to be treated now. Because there is no good medical care in Cuba.
I was going to say, I've never heard that about Cuba
before. No, but Michael Moore said it's the best medical care in the world is in Cuba.
Really?
Because it's all
That's
free to the people.
To
yeah.
Oh, well, there's a difference between what's free and what's good.
That's why all of the Cuban officials and everybody leave the country to get medical care elsewhere.
And it kind of gives them deal with PetroChina on shale gas.
Oh, yeah, because the problem is that, here's a good one. The Obama administration has relented on shale, on getting petroleum from shale. Only problem is they said that you can't use the method that you're using to get it because it pollutes. And basically what happens is in China, the company there has been hit with the same thing. That if it's caused by pollution, the United States is not going to buy it. So therefore, I got you another good one. You got to love this one. The most pro-business in American history, pro-business administration in American history today decided to put every farmer in the United States out of work.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. He has decided now that all farmers are partaking in interstate commerce, even if they only sell in your own community. Yeah,
really?
And they're going to have to obey the same rules as interstate commerce. They're now going to have union truckers move their stuff. They're going to have to have special permits to use any of their equipment.
Oh, wait a minute. What happens to the farmers markets that have grown so popular in the last few years?
Well, that's said screw you, because they said they have to do this for fairness. No, Obama, the unions are basically wanting to stick it to the farmers and haul all of their equipment. Farmers can't afford it. You can basically get around it if you buy brand new General Motors trucks.
What?
Our brand new government approved tractors and trailers. It's a stimulus program for his businesses again, so.
And constitution framers are flawed like today's politicians.
No. They wrote something that today's politicians could never agree on, so.
I know, and they did agree on Anamachi bubbleism from the Mark Twain of the animal kingdom.
Okay, I love this one. There are liars, there are damn liars, and there's professional liars called politicians.
Ooh.